And then on Sunday, believe it or not, it's already Survivor Series. And so when Survivor Series is over, it's going to be myself and Vinny and Craig. And we are going to be recapping the Survivor Series live for our Twitch homies, twitch.tv/F4WVideo. And that will also be a fundraiser for the Great Fowler. Had a lot of medical issues over the last year. We've done one fundraiser. Time to do another one. Help this guy out. So if you got a couple of bucks spare change lying around, all of your cheers coming up on Sunday are going to go directly to the Great Fowler. So don't throw any cheers in today. Forget it. Save those for Sunday so that it all goes to a great cause. The Great Fowler, in fact. Great Cause Fowler, I like to call him. Despite competition in the form of the NBA draft on ESPN, Dynamite averaged 850,000 viewers last night on TNT, its highest number since September. WWE NXT up slightly from last week, but trailed Dynamite distantly. I didn't write these words. Averaging 638,000 viewers. NXT's best number since Halloween Havoc. Gap of 212,000 viewers, biggest between the two shows since July 22. Dynamite was 7th on cable. 7th on cable. That week that we had the election fallout, when the top 50 were all news, they didn't even trend. Well, now they're number 7. Should tell you about the news shows. 18 to 49, 0.37. The second highest total in that category for Dynamite in 2020. Just trailing the January 15th episode of the show. NXT was not in the top 50. 56 with a 0.14. The second lowest NXT has ever done on the USA Network. So, on the same night, with the same competition, AEW did its second highest 18 to 49 of the year 2020, while NXT did the second lowest 18 to 49 in history, the entire time they've ever been on the USA Network. So, clearly, something that NXT is doing is not blowing the minds of the 18 to 49 audience. I mean, I don't want to blame anybody in particular. I'm sure they're all great guys. But they opened up that show with a Leon Ruff angle where at that point in the show, he was still being portrayed as a comedy geek as the North American champion. And they immediately followed that up with a Cameron Grimes-Dexter Lumis blindfold match. I mean, hello. The second, like, hour and a half of the show was awesome. But, man, the first half hour of that show was death. And they paid for it here in the 18 to 49 ratings. Mike, any thoughts on any of this?
Not really. More for less from NXT and more for AEW's point of view. This was the number that I think a lot of people thought they would get coming off of the pay-per-view. They have not been below 750,000 people in quite some time, and, you know, good, back into the 800s again. It's, you know, been since September that that's happened. So let's see if they're able to continue a run here and stay in the eights, because, yeah, that's the big thing. They've touched nine, you know, been close to it. On September 16th, it was 886,000 people. And, you know, that's their biggest thing, is they just have to keep aiming towards a million people, and they're going to be the ones that bring up the entire average of the way things are going, because we're still around 1.5 million wrestling fans roundabouts that tune in every Wednesday. But if that number is going to drive forward, it's obviously going to come from AEW, because the way the demographics are showing for NXT, you know, you just got to shrug your shoulders. And it's not just NXT, as you and Dave has discussed on Wrestling Observer Radio, that over 50 audience is pushing WWE in general. They are just not reaching the younger fans, and they're just not sparking them into anything right now. And it's unfortunately going across all three shows. And that's too bad.
If you're a big fan of these video clips here on YouTube, you're missing out on full-length shows. Down there on the bottom right-hand side of the screen, click that join button, and when you sign up, you'll have full access to all of the shows that we've got up on YouTube, over 300 at current count, Wrestling Observer Live, The Bryan and Vinny Show, and Figure Four Daily with Filthy Tom Lawler and Lance Storm. Hit the join button, sign up today. You can also click subscribe, and you'll always be alerted as to when new shows and clips are available.